Welcome to my dear students. Now we are discussing physics second year electric charges and fields class 4. Now we are already discussed electric field. Now discuss about electric field, electric lines of forces. Electric lines of forces. Okay. What is the electric lines of force? The unit positive charge is installed in electric field or moving in electric field in a path, then the path of the charge is called electric lines of force. So again, the unit positive charge is moving in an electric field in path, then the path of the charge is called electric lines of force. But these are imaginary lines. We will now discuss properties of electric lines of force. No properties. Okay. So the first one, actually the electric lines of force are started at positive charge. At positive charge. And end with the negative charge. The electric lines of force are started at positive charge and end with the negative charge. Next one, these are continuous lines without any break and open loops. These are continuous lines without any break and open loops. Now third one is the most important part. Any two electric lines of force does not intersect each other. Any two electric lines of force does not intersect each other. Why? Because here these are intersects. Why? Because this point electric field have two direction. But already discussed electric field is a vector quantity. Now the electric field is only vector. It has no two direction, but it is impossible. Second means, now here any two electric lines of force does not intersect each other. Why? Because this point here the electric field have two direction, it is impossible. Now the fourth one, the tangential of electric field is direction. The tangential of electric field lines of force is direction. It gives electric field direction. These are properties of the electric lines of force. The first one, what is the electric lines of force? The unit positive charge is moving in electric field in a path, then the path of the charge is called electric lines of force. But these are imaginary lines. Now the properties of electric lines of force. Actually, the electric lines of force are started at positive charge and end with the negative. Now the next one, these are continuous lines without any break and open loops. Any two electric lines of force does not intersect each other. Why? Because at the point electric field have two direction, it is impossible. It is the most important point. And fourth one, the tangential of electric lines of force is gives electric field direction. These are properties of electric lines of force. Now for example, individual positive charge, now we can observe it is the positive charge plus Q. Whatever the electric lines of force, now we are observed, these are started from the positive charge. Now we can observe it is the arrow symbol is not started. It's the direction. It is the positive charge. Positive charge. Okay. And the negative charge, now we have observed, negative charge. It is the negative charge. But electric lines of force end with the negative charge. Now we have observed, end with the at a negative charge. It is the individual negative charge. It is the negative charge. Negative charge. But in the couple charges, yeah, plus Q and minus Q. Now we have observed. It is the plus Q and minus Q. Now the charges are plus 2 minus Q. Start end. It is the arrow symbol. And start end. It is the arrow symbol. Now we have. Okay. But now here. Here. Okay. Now from this side, here positive and negative charge. Positive and negative. This is the couple for this. Here positive charge is here, start up, and here end. Now we are observed positive to negative. And but not is the negative to positive, only positive next to this. This is about electric lights, of course. Now next intensity of electric field. Now discuss this of intensity of electric field. Next topic is intensity of electric field. What is the definition of intensity of electric field? Now, the force experienced by unit positive test charge is known as intensity of electric field. Once again, the force experienced by unit positive test charge is known as intensity of electric field. Actually, it is denoted by capital E. Then we can write the E is equal to F by Q naught. It is the intensity of electric field. Once again, definition. The unit positive, the force experienced by unit positive test charge is known as intensity of electric field. Now, the E is equal to F by Q naught. It is the formula of intensity of electric field. Now, units of the intensity of field. The force units is what to them? E is equal to here, Newton. The charge is what to them? Coulombs. Coulombs. Okay, it is the units of intensity of electric field. If we now discuss about expression for intensity of electric field. Intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Due to a point charge. Now, once again, expression for intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Now, this is the topic. Now, we are considering two charges. It is the charges Q. It is known as point charge at O. And another charge is at point B. It is a test charge Q naught. The distance between two charges is known as R. Once again, let us consider two charges O, Q and Q naught. Here Q is point charge, Q naught is test charge. The distance between two charges is capital R. But these are like charges. Which force acts on the charges? Repulsion force. But these are unlike charges. Which force acts on the charges between two charges is attraction force. The force is F. If now we find the intensity of electric field due to a point charge at point B, this direction, electric field direction. Now this we find about the intensity of electric field. But if you know, according to Coulomb's inverse square law. Now what is the formula? Now already discussed. What is the formula then? F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. The force between Q and Q naught. Then you can write Q naught by Q and Q naught by R square. It is the equation number 1. But by the definition of intensity of electric field, what is the formula then? E is equal to F by Q naught. It is the equation number 2. From 1 and 2. Now here E is equal to F by Q naught. Then F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square. Now replace F on this equation 2. Now we can write, now we get the final equation. F means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square upon but Q naught. Q naught. It is known as F, then F replace 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square, then Q naught Q naught. Now Q naught Q naught is cancelled. Finally, we get the equation, then E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. It is the intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Okay, once again. Now, what is the topic? Expression for the intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Now, let us consider two charges. What is the Q means? Point charge at O. Another charge Q naught is known as test charge at point P. The distance between two charges is or the attraction or repulsion force between two charges is F. But you know, according to Coulomb's Silvestre law, what is the formula? F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square. But by the definition of intensity of electric field, then E is equal to F by Q naught equation 2. From 1 and 2, what happened? Now we are observed. Then equation 1 is substituting equation 2 at place F. Then 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught by R square F means. By Q naught, then Q naught is cancelled. Finally, we get the equation E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. It is the intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Okay.